state. I'm tall enough. Okay. For next form, the doctor persists, now it turned to be like a surgical case, right? I want to say that now my topic is not highlight. The next is that really highlights about the 30 years of Dr. Hudup, the gate hand surgeon in Thailand also. Okay, surgery and tennis elbow. Why need to surgery and the proper timing for judgment? This is the two key that you need to answer and when to decide to surgery for the tennis elbow, right? We need to understand that this is the tennis elbow, like a lateral epicondylitis, is a midnomoma. It's not, the lesion is not at the lateral epicondy, and it's not an inflammatory process. It's a degeneration. So we need something like a provide healing of the tendon there. They have a neovascularized fibrin laid out, collagen production and maturation. So it looks like that the treatment of lateral epicondylitis most of the time is normally it heal. Yeah. The aim is to reduce the pain and provide progressive load. Okay. And the progressive, concentric and eccentric resistive exercise is a key. And also the thing that Dr. Persist said already, so adequate multi-modality in conservative treatment like a medicine, stimulus healing, less activity, modification, exercise is a key to success in conservative treatment. But when you decide to surgery, if the you said that it failed conservative treatment, we have evidence that if you prolong the conservative treatment than 6 months, success rate may be less than 10%. So most of the time, if you have the patient that complain about 6 or 9 months of the pain, maybe that is a proper time to decide what to do next, right? Keep in your mind, next one, it next is to misdiagnosis. Because the tennis elbow, most of the time in the practice, more it is the I think that is common diagnosis for the lateral elbow pain, right? So, but the thing is, it's not just only the lateral epicondylitis that cause of the pain. They have many causes of a pain in for make the lateral elbow pain. Example like this, like a tennis elbow, PIGA, cartilage injury, or even instability. But most of the time, you don't recognize it. In our study that we test on the arthroscope for the chronic case that needs surgery, we found only that have just 17% of the evidence of the tennis elbow. It looked like that, no, not like a Bible to say that it is a tennis elbow if you have a lateral elbow pain. What is in the real practice, most of the time, if you have the lateral elbow pain, you choose the steroid injection because Dr. Persist also said that it have improved pain and improved in short period, short follow up, right? Because after shot, they improve pain a lot. But what do we have? It look like that show that no benefits in the long term compared to exercise and NSAIDs. And if you go back to the first slide, I said that it's maybe it can heal by themselves. But if you use a steroid, it can list up another complication, especially many injection in there. We also have the published already about the automatic posterolateral rotatory instability from steroid injection, or maybe I can say that the automatic instability related with steroid injection. Especially you have a two or three time injection. Some people that have a multi-puncture in there also can make a weak lateral collateral ligament. Because most of the people practice is an injection on top on the lateral epicondy directly. Okay, maybe it's like a iatrogenic tenotomy already, or ligament cut already. So after failed conservative treatment, you have two choices. two choice of the surgery. It's next of the next step of a conservative treatment is a choice of surgery. You will have a choice of surgery like open or maybe arthroscopic surgery, right? The choice of surgery, if I said the open surgery, most of the time we recognize about nerve, mini open surgery. The concept of nerve is a divide of a pathology, fibroangiocartilage tissue that have the degeneration and divide it out and repair it back. But the bad thing is you need to cut from the good thing because most of the time the lesion inside the tendon or the ligament, ECRB tendon, and then you need to close it back. It's like you need to go from the good thing until you go inside to the pathology so it can make a weakness of the ECRB. The bad thing of the open surgery is even it be an open approach, but the viewing is so suck. It cannot. You cannot see anything, you see? The lesion in there, you just open small window in there and they say that the lesion, the wound, it may be 1 or 2 centimeters. Yeah, it lies, but you cannot see anything inside. And you can say that I said that from the first that they have many cause of the lateral could be a cause of chronic elbow pain, right? You will not see something like this if you have open. This one is like a chronic lateral elbow pain for a long time. He is 54 years old. They have a chronic of like a pica impingement inside. You can see that in the same patient, he also have something like a cartilage lesion impingement inside already. And we can see many structure damage in there. They have the impingement and have a friction erosion of the cartilage at the capitulum. They also have a impingement and have an impinge like a foot pin on the capitulum also. They also have the pica that have rupture in there, so make a painful and click in sensation in there. Even sometimes they have a fraying cartilage on the little head also. That is a good, give a bad prognosis for the patient already because they have a miss and neglect in there. And also you cannot done anything like an open surgery. You can see something like a test about the instability. I don't know for sure why it's reverse the picture. And if you use arthroscope, you can done repair or reconstruction the lateral collateral back immediately if you detect it there. So arthroscopic surgery the benefit in that they have an interarticular lesion evaluation and treatment. If the be tenable, we also can directly divide and to the lesion, and for our concept is to divide, so it release the force that transfer to the origin of an extensor tendon. Okay, this is a process that we done. This patient, we have document about the pica combined with the tennis elbow. That is quite common scene in our surgery. We have many patients in there. So we go inside and divide the pica. If you do the open surgery like a nurse, you cannot do anything inside. So you just go in, open it there and divide the tendon and repair it back. You cannot take care about the pica. I still have time, so you can take a look and enjoy my video clip. Okay. And after that, we go to take care about the ECRB, and we try to, after we finish then, and then we done some tenotomy to release the force to the ECRB origin. They have many variety of the impingement inside of the like a pica impingement and the cause of the pain in there. So I can say that lateral elbow pain, many causes come from the pica. and not also in the front, in the back of the elbow also. They also have the like a lateral olecranon pica that can cause a pain of the in the lateral elbow pain. So in the arthroscope cannot do something like that. It can make a misdiagnosis and meet you may miss it if you just open the bite. So the key for me, if you want to successfully solve and good clinical outcome from the surgery, you need to have a good evaluation and a diagnosis, and the key of the success and the period of the and timing to decide to surgery is also the key. If you neglect it for long and longer and longer, you will risk of the from complication from medicine or from complication from the steroid injection in there. So if you have the diagnosis, good diagnosis, especially even not preoperative only, but also intraoperative only, arthroscope maybe is a key success for that. So for amelioration is a key one. So tennis elbow, ไม่ใช่สรณะ it's not like a Bible, okay? Get the right diagnosis before the operation. Because if you done it and you said that I can done, but you forget many things, especially at the back of the elbow, you will get a suck results. And less invasive and proper treatment in the proper timing is a key to successful also. Thank you.